Good afternoon and welcome to the Harbor Hangar. Today is wing day on the C-47. I got one wing halfway done, sort of. So by halfway done, I mean it is covered top and bottom on the outer panel. So we got spars and everything in there. The ailerons are hooked up. They are done and running and hinged. And then it's just the inboard section that we need to stuff with engine things. But so this is left wing is covered halfway. And after I finished covering it, I shared a couple of little videos with some close friends and they said, hey, that would be make a great time lapse. Josh Orchard. And I said, oh yeah, I'll remember that for the next one because I didn't record any of this. So that's what we're going to do right now. We are going to do the right hand wing. Here, I'll show you the inside of what it looks like before we cover it up. We got carbon spars going down to reinforce the foam spars all the way. And we've got this spar, like angle reinforcement. That is what sort of holds the dihedral or help to set it. And that transmits the load from these spars into through the center spar. Through to other sides. There's other gonna be more tube joiner pieces that are not shown right now because I have to put them in with the wings together. Anyway, there's more. But so this is what it looks like before we cover it. There is the aileron servo hooked up, and yeah, that motor mount is already attached. This one's not yet because I ran out of wood pieces, so I just got some more, so we're gonna cut some more of those. But the other thing that I forgot was joining the leading edge of this thing was quite interesting. I will put a picture in now while I'm talking to show you what I did. I laid down three strips of strapping tape, the bifilament strapping tape. I put three of those down on the table, sticky side up, and held in place at either end by just some blue tape, going longer than I needed it to. And then I lifted the bottom half of the wing onto the tape, stuck it down, marked the gap that I wanted on the tape, and then lifted and placed the upper skin onto the tape, stuck it down. And so now we're at the point where we can fold it over. Just like any other small, you know, FT foam board plane, we're gonna do a fold over wing. It's just giant. And instead of hot glue, because hot glue is super convenient and cools quickly and is really, you know, great for quick building, not so great for strength and weight. The strength to weight ratio on hot glue is not the best. However, Gorilla Glue is awesome, not sponsored. it's great. The strength to weight ratio on Gorilla Glue is great. And I don't need quick setting, like quick cooling stuff. And I don't really need to use epoxy either, which is more expensive than Gorilla Glue. So we're using Gorilla Glue. And we're gonna put that basically everywhere that is sticking up here. So along all the spar tops, along the wingtip ear in the leading edge, just like you would do if you were putting down hot glue doing an FT fold over wing. The only difference is I don't have, you know, big enough arms to lay on this thing for several hours. So we're going to use my handy dandy trusty ballast weights to lay down on there. And this is the other fun thing that I did with this wing. Because we're laying this on the tables to keep it flat while it sets. After we do the Gorilla Glue and after we fold the wing over, we need to anchor the wing down. So I'm gonna do two things. I'm gonna put the ballast weights on the top of the wing to hold the skin. Actually, I'm doing three things. Probably more than that, but whatever. And then I'm taping also along the trailing edge right here, taping the top trailing edge to the bottom along the inside the hinge line here, and also back here it's going to come to about right there. So we're going to tape that down to hold the trailing edge down, and then I'm going to line up the leading edge with the edge of the table. And underneath here, I've got a bunch of blue tape strips ready. And they are going to grab on to the leading edge of the wing and hold the leading edge straight to the table. And then the weights will hold the skin down and provide contact for the Gorilla Glue. And the other cool thing about Gorilla Glue is it expands as it cures. So any little gaps that we have in there, as long as they're not too big, will get filled up as the foam expands. Let me see if I can have an example. Yeah, here, like this. Oops, where can I see? Here we go. Yeah, this piece. It expanded and dripped out. Alrighty, what else? Oh yeah. And I'm also gonna use a strip of foam board. I put this piece of foam under the trailing edge right about there. What that does is by holding down the leading edge and holding down the skin and lifting up on the trailing edge of the wing tip, I put a little bit of a twist into the wing tip. And the twist going trailing edge up, leading edge down. And that gives me washout. And the reason, why do you want washout then? Because I don't want tip stalls. So washout is basically a twist in the wing from zero angle at the root, theoretically, just one example. So zero angle of attack at the root and then negative angle of attack at the wing tip gives you what they call washout. And what that means is as you're climbing and as you're pulling positive angle of attack, your wing root is getting a higher angle of attack than your wing tip. So you tend not to stall because the thinner wing cord on the tip will tend to stall sooner than the bigger wing cord on the wing root because the bigger wing cord holds onto the air better. So putting washout on the wing tip will keep the wingtip from getting too high an angle of attack and stalling, and then you tip over and then you crash and then you're sad. So don't do that. Quick and dirty washout. All right, now I'm gonna set you guys up there on the ladder and start a time lapse, and we're gonna get to gorilla gluing this wing together. Let's go. And that's all there is to it. The easy as that. And now we wait. In case you noticed, I did not spray water on the Gorilla Glue, which it says to do because that's what like activates the cure, but it is really humid today. So I'm just sort of counting on the moisture in the air and also just letting it cure basically overnight. So that's why I didn't use that. Usually I do on smaller pieces where I didn't want it to set up faster. I've got my little water bottle, but I didn't want to get water on the foam board paper. So we'll just let the natural moisture in the air do its job and we'll come back tomorrow and see where we're at. We got two wings coming along very, very close to putting them together. Thanks for hanging out with me in the Harbor Hangar. See you next time. Bye.